Let me say this. Madam President, I believe that we can deal with our debt responsibly. And I say that having been through a year and a half working on this issue. I'm still not an expert, but I know a lot more about it now than I did at the start. And we worked together, Democrats and Republicans, on the President's Deficit Commission and came up with a plan supported by 11 out of the 18 members, including myself, and a number of Republican senators and Democratic senators, Senator Kent Conrad, the chairman of the Budget Committee. We all supported it. We believed there was a bipartisan way to reduce the debt by $4 trillion over 10 years and to do it in a sensible, balanced way, bringing into consideration not only spending cuts, but also reform of our entitlement programs and revenue. On the entitlement programs, many senators and many people get nervous when you start talking about Social Security and Medicare. I will tell you, I am committed to these programs. I believe in them. The reason I've stayed with this conversation is because I want to make certain that at least one, or maybe more, at the table feel as I do about the importance of Social Security and Medicare. I believe we can make reasonable changes in each of those programs, preserve the basic benefit structure, particularly for working Americans, and make sure that they have the promise of the security which these programs bring. I know that people in retirement wonder if the savings are going to last, whether the pension will be around, but you know, they just know for sure Social Security will be there. I want to make sure that promise is kept, not just for the next 25 years, but 50 years beyond and even beyond that. We can do it, and making modest changes now can achieve it. On Medicare, health insurance for elderly and disabled people, Medicare is a bigger challenge. In 6 years or so, we start running out of money. Let's get serious about this. Let's do things now that will avoid that crisis. We don't want that. We want to make sure that people have the peace of mind of knowing that they have health insurance. We can do it in a sensible, responsible way. Let's do it together, not with the determination of ending the program. I'll never let that happen on my watch, but to make sure that the program has a long life, a solid life, a solvent life. And when it comes to revenue, there is a way to do this. $1.2 trillion is lost each year in our tax code to deductions and credits and exclusions and special treatment given to some and not to others. We can take a look at that and do it in a way that says we're going to preserve the basics that we need. Yes, we need the mortgage interest deduction. Yes, we need the charitable deduction. Yes, we need to make sure that people have their health insurance exclusions from their income. We can do that and still lower the amount of tax expenditures and use that money to reduce the deficit. That is a reasonable way of raising revenue in a sensible manner. Men and women of good faith in both political parties can do this. Let's pass Senator Harry Reid's proposal this week. Let's avert this crisis. Let's tackle the long-term deficit and debt challenge in a balanced way by putting everything on the table. We did it with the Deficit Commission. We've done it with the Gang of Six. We can do it again. What we need is the support of the American people to encourage us on beyond our critics. That's always going to happen. But beyond our critics to the kind of conclusion where people will once again feel a little pride in what goes on here in Washington on Capitol Hill.